Alright, first thing we're going to want to do is turn on the laser. Connect your USB cable to your laptop USB port. Once you have the laser engraver turned on, you can go over to your laptop where you have Artiworks opened. In the last video, you remember that we set up all of our lines to be either a scan or a cut. Scan being blue, cut being red. Also, do make sure that you have the USB cable from the laser engraver connected to your laptop USB port. The one thing that I added that is different from last video is I added a circle using the ellipse tool. The reason I did that is we can make this a keychain. We can use a key ring and have that set up on our keys. The ellipse tool is located right here, and it's simply just click and drag to form your circle. I did make the circle a red line so that we can cut through and have that cut through entirely with the laser engraver. All that's left to do now is click on the download button. Once we click on the download button with our USB cable connected to the laptop, we should be able to download this file over to the laser engraver. All we have to do is type in our initials here, click OK, and we should be ready to go. It says file download success. Click OK there. And now you can go over to the laser. Next, you may open the hatch. Place the material onto the laser bed. Please remember the hatch door is heavy, and it will slam if you let go when closing. Make sure to hold onto the handle the entire way down. On the control panel, there are these four green arrows. They are used to move the laser. With your material loaded onto the bed, use the green arrows to move the laser directly above your material. Make sure that the laser nozzle and touch sensor are both directly above the material surface. Next, you may press the ZU button and use the green arrows to navigate to the option labeled autofocus. Press enter. The laser will then move down on the Z-axis until the touch sensor touches the material. This is why it's important to make sure that your material is directly below the nozzle and touch sensor. With the laser autofocus to the thickness of the material, locate the origin point by placing the laser nozzle at the top right corner of your material. You may then close the hatch. Remember that the hatch is heavy. Hold on to the handle all the way through. We can set the origin by pressing the origin button. This makes it so the laser knows its starting position, which should be at the top right of our material. Next, press the File button. This will open all the files that have been downloaded to the memory of the laser. You will notice that our design is at the top of the list. To select this design, you can simply press the Enter button. This will open the selected design, and it will show you the cut scan line settings. Next, you can press the Frame button. This will cause the laser to form a frame or rectangle that shows you how big your design will be. As I press the frame button, you'll see that the laser does start at the origin and then forms a rectangle around where it will be lasering the design. This is useful for making sure that your design will fit on the material. You are now ready to press start. Press start on the machine and watch it laser your design. When the laser is done, you'll hear a beep. Once you hear that beep, you can use the up arrow to move the laser away from the material to make it easier to retrieve your design. Next, open up the hatch to retrieve your design. You can remove the material and set the material to the left side of the laser. Congratulations, you've completed your very first laser engraved project. Good work.